Assalamualaikum friends, it's your Dr. Fatma. Today we are going to study sideroblastic anemia. The quick review of it. Sideroblastic anemia. Sidro means iron, blastic, there will be immature cell and anemia, decreased RBC, decreased hemoglobin and decreased oxygen carrying capacity. As you can see here in the diagrams, that there is iron accumulated in the RBC because there is defect in the formation of the porphyrin ring. So in the hemoglobin, which consists of the heme and the globin, and here it can't carry the oxygen, which is its function, properly. The main features are dyserythropoiesis, inability to utilize iron, ring sideroblast. Ring sideroblast is iron-laden mitochondria form a ring around the nucleus. Are inherited and acquired. In the inherited, X-link mainly affect the boys and there is mutation in the ALAS gene. In the acquired form, first is the primary, then secondary. In the primary is a type of myelodysplastic syndrome, and the secondary, to memorize it, like arc met, from the like, lead toxicity, arc anemia, alcohol, rheumatoid arthritis and carcinoma, and med, myeloid leukemia, myeloproliferative disorder, malabsorption and megaloblastic anemia. And from the D, drugs, isoniazid and phenytoin. How can you memorize that? Like arc med is a mnemonic for sideroblastic anemia, because in the sideroblastic anemia, we see ring formation, ring sideroblast, and from the ring, arc, and like arc med in the sideroblastic anemia. Diagnosis is on the basis of the clinical judgment and the lab finding. In the clinical judgment, you will see enlarged liver damage, enlarged spleen, heart disease, fatigue, kidney damage, diarrhea, other symptoms of anemia like palpitation, difficulty in breathing, change in the stool color, heart conditions, etc. In the lab findings, you will do the complete blood count, peripheral blood smear, iron studies, bone marrow studies. In the CBC, you will find dimorphic picture. In the congenital, MCV will be normal or decreased. In the acquired, MCV will be normal or increased. In the peripheral blood smear, you will see basophilic stippling and the Pappenheimer bodies. Basophilic stippling are RNA accumulated, and the Pappenheimer bodies are the iron granules eaten by the phagosomes. Then iron study, increased serum iron, increased serum ferritin and decreased TIBC, total iron binding capacity. And in the bone marrow studies, you will see erythroid hyperplasia. How you are going to treat the patient? Remove the toxin, do the phlebotomy, induce the fluid in the blood or bloodletting, the defroxamine, and the administer pyridoxine, thiamine or folic acid, and when the condition is so severe, bone marrow transplant and the liver transplant. Thank you so much for listening, and don't forget to subscribe the channel.